that crowd here. I got to perform a little bit of maintenance on this thing. The fans have started to be a bit sad. Let's put it on. I'm not sure if it'll be picked up in the mic, but you can hear this one is not running very clean. So what I did is I went and ordered from Prusa the fans that are related to this. So both the hot end fan and then the part cooling fan. And then they were kind enough to include a set of new tie ties. So a little bit of extra service. So I need to sadly take apart this harness here and the back connections and stuff. I won't be going into incredible detail when I'm doing this. It'll be like generally showing how to do it, because the instructions are actually online if you need to do this. I mean, how to install the fans. But I just thought it'd be kind of cool to follow on when I'm doing this. So let's get into it. So, I think I'll start with opening the top harness here. So, I think I damaged anything. So, what's next to open the electronics box. Thank you. whole thing off, I think. Nice thing with Prusa stuff is that it's all color coded, so I just need to find the wire that looks like this, and that's the fan. Easy to see. Black on black, it's not easy to see. Oh, that's not going to be easy to get out of. Yes. That was just by feel. I couldn't see anything. Well, pull that back. And then we need to identify this one. Same type of click connector. It's just by feel. Oh, that just went by feel also. That is just too cramped in that box. So, now we put it straight up to there. And then we need to take the back plate off. So disconnect the can't remember now if I need to take the hot end cables out or what was that centerpiece screwed into? The screw on the other side. Also. No. Well, if we're going to take this back plate off to get through that channel, then I think we need to also disconnect, sadly, hot end cables. I say, hate working black on black. So, here we go. So now we can take the fan cables through. To turn the printer around and organize a bit of stuff so then we can continue. So now we can take off the old fans. One of these is longer, so one has to try and keep track of that. Which one of these was the longer one? It's that one in the corner. Yep. So keep that as reference. Longer. And then it was like this. Trying to keep it in the same mode. Yeah, because that's hold on to the side. Oops. can get it in the picture. So that's the duct for the port. Oh, that's the fans off. Well, we got to try and see if we can get the new ones in place. Try and put the... Oh, got some grease on the table. I need to get something to wipe that up. So let's get the new fans in place. So let's try this one first. So as soon as I stopped filming, I got the screw in. Now the cable's rooted. It needs to be behind the fan here and behind the fan there, and then it needs to actually exit in the groove at all at the same time. So it's like really a little bit of a nightmare to get in place. And yeah, it's going to be the long screw. And then again, you know, this part cooling fan duct dropped out like it seems to want to do all the time. Try and screw that one in next. Got it. Let's double check. Get that there. So then we can tighten these up again. So it's tight. That one's tight. This one back. These fans suffer from these little wispy parts of the PLA that probably gets into them, so probably they don't have a very nice life. I think the part cooling fan is probably more protected. Well, maybe not, because it can also get in there. Okay, so far so good, and now it's to so that's already rooted into the back. Coming right there. Looks like the ones that come on the bottom. So now we need to root the part cooling fan cable. Somehow. Not great filming black against black. Well, I hope this video will be of general instructional use. So you could actually look the instructions up online. And then watch this video, and then you'll probably be able to do it. because then you would understand what the instructions are talking about. And then of course the instructions are about mainly about building a new printer. Through the wrong gap. Come on. Needs to go down there. And then it needs to be behind the pin sensor cable. So I had it before. Something like that. So that should be. I got force it up there a bit. So when it comes up there, it's not in the, not getting heated by the fan. I actually don't know if, I don't remember if the fan is pulling air through there or what is it doing. You have a direction for airflow. Funny how one forgets things. Well, could be that it's pulling the air through, but anyway, it's probably good to keep the cable out of the way. Anyway, I think it's definitely long enough. That's still not the correct gap. Needs to come one down. Be careful. Use a magnifying glass with a light. See the. Yeah. I better actually double check on this side. Let's actually get it through. Yeah. It needs to be under the belt in the duct that's going through to the other side. Otherwise, you will have such a blimps. And getting grease everywhere. Oh. Well, of course it's not as bad as working up on machines. Okay, so that's that. So I'll turn the printer around so we can start routing the cable. Whew, some ice water. Oh. So now we need to straighten this cable out, the part cooling fan. Here, the back plate, I have to remind myself to test the fans before I put all the cabling together. So careful. Actually don't like how all these cables hanging around. Always a risk that one of the cables will break. So now we should try and no, that one, on that side, and then this one. Oh no, not pulling it through, I have to remember not through. Needs to have a bit of flexibility there. And let's not pull up that. Ah! I better screw the middle screw in. Really always a bit scared of crossing the threads. Not tightening too much. So we have the fans installed in the front. Should be all the screws in place. So now it's just the cable part. And then this one starts from over here, somewhere. Can't exactly remember where. Thought this plugged in somewhere. There. I think. Maybe I will have to cheat and look at the instructions. It's just that I seem to remember there was a special place for this when it comes into the electronics box. Oh, there is a hole there. No, that's just the... Ah, no, it was on the side. Ah, oh, black on black, it's really hard to see. But there is a hole for this to go through. There. Just have to make sure one doesn't push it in too aggressively. I think that was the hole for it. And the sad thing is it pushes itself into the electronics box, so... But I think we'll put that in when we've got everything else in place. I always take photographs of things and I think, oh, I can just remember how things go together, and then, no, not really.
Okay, this is a bit strange. Those two going down, as I remember. Oops. Falling off the table. Two of them that are going down. Let's just see, I got it in the right hole. I couldn't have got away without taking the bottom ones off because I couldn't get the back plate off without. Yeah. So anyway, there's two of them that go down, and three of them that go up. And I got it the wrong way around. Have I got it the wrong way around? Yes, I have it the wrong way around. Let me try and think. Should have it the right way. Now I need to check I got it in the right hole. The one going down. Yeah. Otherwise, not be able to get this together then. A bit scared one tightens too much. Alright. Hope that I have it now. Oh, because I just see if those don't look like. Very far away from the holder end, and the PID sensor, the wires are way up. Okay, next one. It has to be this way around. In the wrong hole, so I have to cut that one. Oh, black on black is such a nightmare. So, goodbye. Try to check. So that goes on like that. And this needs to go into the one that's gonna go down. It is not easy to see. that one. Let's just double check. It's actually easier to see it from this. That should be okay. Seems to be very loose. So, that's a bit better. Could have got that. It's been shaken loose over time. So, hope it's not too loose, not too tight. So, that's the bottom ones on, at least I think this is the order one's supposed to do it in, and now one needs to start putting the and how was it with that tight? Instructions. Was there a place for that? Hardware. Oh, maybe I need to actually look at the instructions to see. Just the hard piece. Here. Like, how did this one start? Totally forgotten. Could be the worst case scenario is that it was supposed to be plugged into something. I think I have to check that one. Okay, so there is a hole, and as I remember, then this one end of it is sharpened, and then one needs to put it into the hole, which is actually a little bit difficult to see now that I have the back cover on. So we have to take the back cover off and find the hole. Sadly, that's the case. So, where is the hole then? Black on black again. Absolute nightmare to see. Again. issues with the center screw again. Why? Everything else seems to be lining up okay. Strange. I have to fiddle with it. I can't get the screws to start. That was strange. It was just a little bit out of line at the bottom. Just had to push it sideways a bit. Okay, well, I'm back in order again. We have this in its initial position. A bit more annoying doing this work when I have multi-material loops. I have all these tubes and all. Okay, so let's double check. So that one's tightened up. Oops, central one. I missed that one. That one's tight. I hope I don't have to unscrew it again. Okay, now then. So, that solves that one, and then I need to double check how the wrapping was to start, but I actually think I do remember. So what you need to do is you need to start the wrapping here. The tricky thing is to bring the bottom cables into the wrap while they as they come naturally around. So pull the cables in the wrap. Remember from last time, I'm not that very good at doing this. So anyway, that's the way you're gonna get it in there. It takes a while, so I won't bore you with the whole process, but you need to put this like on there, and then it needs to be twisted once you got it onto the cable all the way to the electronic box. Then you need to twist it around itself a little bit, so and that takes this whole process takes a while. So back when done. So I think I got it. I just need to get, and remember to put the hard bit goes into a hole in the electronics side of the electronics box, but don't push it down too far. Okay. And you'd still need to put the support, the tie tights in there, but I'm going to try and put this in place first. If it's even possible to get... Oh, did I have it the right way around? This? Another struggle. Nope. And I have to struggle with this. Be back when I'm done. Ah, that wasn't fun, but at least I got it into place. Okay, now it's to these in place. There will be three of them. Let's see if I can position the camera a bit more sane. Three in here. I'll make sure this is the right way around. So it's the first one. And then I think I cheated by adding one more here, but not so tight, just to be able to keep this group together. It's where the cables join from below. I just wanted to give it a little bit extra support so that they don't start dropping out. So, that's done. And the last remaining task is to Put the plug the wires into the electronics box, and then I'm going to have to look at the instructions because I actually visually don't know where they are, and I can't film it because I tried that when I was actually producing the assembly videos, and that was really hard filming the control box. So I recommend that you look at the online manual for which fan needs to be plugged into what plug. So I'll just get that done. Okay, let's switch it on and see what happens. That's just the multi-material. I don't have to care about that. So we have one fan turning, two fans turning. So as long as I presumably plug them into the correct connectors, then we have a printer that is operational. So anyway, so I'm just going to do some test prints with it. Anyway, if you like this, please consider subscribing. Hit the like button. And if you think I've done a good enough job, then you can buy me a cup of coffee. Or there's some merch available. Links are in the description. And see you in the next one.